Obese people with COVID-19 are not only more likely to end up in hospital, but are also more likely to die from the virus.
94% of all coronavirus patients have some underlying condition.
We know that folks that are obese a lot of times have markers in their blood of excessive systemic inflammation.
So you already come in pre-inflamed, and that is what leads to serious infections and death.
People that tragically die from it die because of an exaggerated immune response that attacks the lungs, something called ARDS, or acute respiratory distress syndrome, which ultimately causes death in a tragic minority of people.
So these are the risks: high blood pressure, obesity, and about 30% have diabetes.
Chronic illness, cardiovascular disease, diabetes, past cancer, etc. You're at more risk. You're the one who could get into trouble, and it happens pretty quickly.
Do you got sugar, diabetes? Do you got pressure, high blood pressure, hypertension? You could die in a week. You could not be here.
If you are fat, you are on death row.
The diabetes, the hypertension, the obesity, the asthma, those are the kind of things that wind them up in the ICU and ultimately give them a higher death rate.
Governors should declare keeping our bodies in good health an essential job.
CrossFit Health have a website, free website, where people can go online and look at home exercises.
Oh, there you all are. Yay, hi. See, now I can see everybody on one screen. Good morning, Ron.
Good morning. You've heard me say that we sit in unique possession, you do, of an elegant solution, a solution so elegant it may be optimal to the world's greatest problem. I've gone on record as saying that. It's been saying it for a while. I'm going to say it one more time, and then I'm going to take it apart for you. You sit in unique possession of an elegant solution, so elegant it may be optimal to the world's greatest problem. The uniqueness of the possession is your application of the L1 kernel to your clients. And that is a practice, it's an act, it's an action, it's a thing, it's not an idea, it's not a theoretical. And so you can talk to experts all day long on chronic disease, and everyone's got a theory, an idea, something that should be tried, a whole bunch of only ifs. But what you do when you get up at 4 a.m. to unlock the doors at 5 a.m., by 5:15, you're fucking doing it. It's not a theoretical, it's not a hypothetical, it's not an idea anymore, it's happening. And what is that thing? It's the prevention and reversal of chronic disease. We'll come back to that. Unique possession, in that there are other people with the answer, but yours is in application to an elegant solution. I mean elegant in the mathematician's sense of marked by simplicity and efficacy. In fact, so elegant, so simple, and so effective, I believe it to be optimal. There's the challenge to the world. Prove me wrong. I don't owe anyone any sympathy for the chronically diseased. Not with 15,000 affiliates, not with you doing the work you're doing in your towns. We have been vocal about the risks, the costs, dollars, and souls lost about chronic disease for a long time. Get in between my affiliates and chronic disease. I don't think you can. I don't think you can get more simple. I don't think you can get more effective. There are heart attacks that have been evaded. There's diabetes that will never manifest, and people that might have had strokes that won't. Got people that can go to ground and get back up that hadn't done so without paramedic help for over a decade. And we've seen hundreds of pounds come off. There's no place that's ever going to give you the credit for the prevention. But the reversal makes the same fucking point, no one can take it from you.